strong work ethic ended with a sweet reward for one Beaver County woman. Since the doors first opened in 1914, it's been all about the family at Rosalind Candy Castle.
Meghan Schiller introduces us to a woman hanging up her hairnet after 70 years on the job.
This is a story about finding something you're good at and sticking with it.
Well, Barb retired, and there was another girl here that found another job. She's not coming back this year.
For Becca Wallazin, the fun is only just beginning.
They were like, you want to start tomorrow? And I was like, sure. It was really short notice.
Day one's been rough, but she thinks she'll stay.
As long as Barb. It's possible, maybe. Maybe not quite that long.
Becca, just 19. Barb Mroz, a little bit older.
There's nothing easy about this job. You just have to learn as you go.
Most candy shops have this machine. It's called an enrober. It covers the candy and chocolate. But Barb's specialty is a lost art. She sits over here with these ladies called the dippers.
Probably the last 3 years. Oh, I don't know if I'll be back next year. But she kept coming back.
How's Samantha doing? Okay. Good.
Barb said today would be her last day with her hands covered in chocolate.
It's not only candy production. She was, I'd say, like a den mother to everybody. Everyone looked up to her.
70 years have passed since the camera captured her as a bright-eyed young teen inside Rosalind Candy Castle.
Nowadays, people don't stay with companies. They change jobs.
Her reason for staying so long?
Well, I had a good job, and I like my job, so I was just lucky enough to stay here that long.
Her coworkers through the years gathered to throw her a retirement party, a celebration for all those years of dedication and to all that chocolate.
How do I what?
Keep your figure.
Oh, I put on a lot of weight since I've been here. Everybody does. You try not to, but you do.
In New Brighton, Meghan Schiller, KDKA-TV News.